This video is on solving one-step linear equations, where you add or subtract. The goal is to obtain a variable, which is a letter, a lowercase letter. It can be X, Y, A, B, M, any lowercase letter. Variable means unknown, so it answers your question. You put in the letter for the unknown, and then when you solve for it, you have your question answered. So the variable equals a number. That's what you want to get. So you want to get X equals negative 3, or 14 equals Y. Notice the variable comes first in the first expression, X equals negative 3, and it comes after in the second one. So is that wrong? No, it's not wrong. It's not wrong at all. This is just as correct, 14 equals Y, as X equals negative 3. The only problem is that sometimes when you're doing an assessment, they want a specific answer and they want you to put like X equals and then the number. And that's what you're going to have to do on the assessments for this, so it can read it. A equals 1/2. You can have a fraction equal to the variable. You can have a decimal value equal to the variable, like 7 32/100 equals B. You can have a mixed number. M equals 1,903/4. Okay, so you want the variable equals a number. That's what you want to get to. To reach the goal, we inverse the operations. The inverse operations of addition and subtraction is when I have addition to start, I subtract, because I want to eliminate that number from that side of the equation. So I want to get zero. So that's why I inverse the operations, is to get zero. If I have a minus or a negative, I add the opposite so that I get zero on that one side. Now, whatever you're doing to one side of the equal sign, besides simplifying, you must do to the other side of the equal sign. The equal sign is a balance. Okay, it's a balance. So if you change something on one side, you have to keep that equal sign as that they're equal, not one's bigger than the other one. So you have to balance it. You undo what is happening to the variable by using the inverse operations. This first example, we're going to solve for X. X plus 56 equals 12. There's many ways to solve this, but algebraically, which is going to lead you into the more complicated problems, is that I look for the variable on the one side of the equation. It is on the left-hand side. So I'm looking at what's happening to that variable on the left-hand side. I'm adding 56. So I want to do the inverse operation, which is subtract 56. When I subtract 56 from this side, I have to subtract it from the other side because I need that balance. And I end up with X equals 12 plus negative 56 is negative 44. So I undo the addition by subtraction. And my final answer is X equals negative 44. Solve for X. This time, my variable is still on the left-hand side, but I'm adding a negative 8. A negative is a number. Subtraction is an operation. And I'm adding a negative number, and that's kind of the same as subtracting a positive number. So I want to do the opposite, so I'm going to add a positive 8 so that I get the 0. What I do to one side, I have to do to the other side because I have to maintain that balance. It's got to be balanced. Can't be up and one down. Has to be equal. balance. My answer is x equals 3, because negative 5 plus 8 is 3. So what I'm doing is I'm undoing addition by using subtraction. I'm undoing subtraction by using addition. What you do on one side, you do on the other side.